You know, perhaps we're paying a little bit too much attention to the book of Revelations. Maybe we should pay a little more attention to what Jesus himself has said. Now, I got this from Luke 21, and it mentions it in Matthew and others too, but I'm going to go to Luke because it specifically mentions the Gentiles. And for all of you that just can't wrap your mind around it, since Rome, the Gentiles have ruled the planet, pretty much. And if you look at the first part of Luke 21, all that's already been fulfilled. Already happened. The days of distress and wrath, they will fall by the sword and be taken prisoners to all nations. That's already happened. The Jews have been scattered. You know, it's just here this century, you know, since, what, 48, that Israel came back into existence. So the time of the Gentiles is coming to an end, or fulfillment, as the Bible calls it. The time of the Gentiles has been fulfilled. Now, how can I say this? Because look at what the signs are. There will be signs in the sun, moon, and stars. Now, everybody says, well, we've seen the sun and moon, you know, with the blood moon, tetrad, and eclipses. What about the stars? Has anybody noticed that there's been a lot of sonic booms and falling stars this past year? Could that be a sign? Don't know. Even that big one a couple of years ago over Russia. Boom! Shattered windows out and everything. Does anybody know that the how you say wormwood in Russian? It's called Chernobyl. So these things in the Bible have already been coming to pass. Anyway, so you can read Luke 21 and pay special attention to verses 24 through 28. Oh, the roaring and tossing of the sea. Hey, this century, what have we had? Two major tsunamis, the one that caused Fukushima, and then there was one in the Indian Ocean that wiped out hundreds of thousands of people. Sounds like waves roaring to me. I'm kind of curious to see what the heavenly bodies will be shaking. That sounds pretty scary. I'd say that would be next on the list. Heavenly bodies shaken. What could that be? But we'll find out, I'm sure, soon enough. So, while everybody's looking at that, the end of the time of the Gentiles. Let's look at some more coincidences. We got 9/11, the collapse of 2007, I think it was 2008, economic collapse then, all this Shemitah stuff coming due with the Blood Moon Triad, all this, and we're the Gentiles, and as the United States, turning away from God, banning the Bible in schools, states passing homosexuality. Oh, the church has to marry homosexuals. See, homosexuals ain't happy with minding their own business. They want to be up in our business. But they don't want to tolerate Christianity, you know. So that's why they're persecuting us right now. It's hateful to be a Christian. They want to shove it down our throat. No, I'm going to put it that way. But anyway. So these things are all coming to pass. Everything that's been prophesied is coming to pass. I mean, there's no denying it. So I'm waiting, you know, after the last blood moon. What could happen? I don't know. What could possibly happen? Think about it. We got a police state. Police are armed like the military. Of course, Obama said he wanted to do that when when he was running for president. He said, oh, we need a homeland force as strong as our military. So he's cutting the military, building up the police state. Who's the police for? Us. The Gentiles, we're coming on a totality. Well, we are. We're there. The Constitution's gone. The only reason I'm allowed to make this video is because nobody's going to listen to it. Okay, we got that. $18 trillion in debt. Oh, Europe, they're on a fiat currency thing too. And then we're poking the bear, which has nukes, lots of nuclear weapons, thousands of nuclear weapons. I encourage everyone to read the book 1 Second After. Now, in that book, I think it's Korea or somebody. You know, they pop one off over Europe, Japan, United States, the Gentiles. We're all gone. Lights out. Lights out. So, you know, the United States got, we're going to retaliate. We're going to put the lights out over Russia. Lights out for everybody. Do you think that would cause the end of the time of the Gentiles? Yeah. That would be the end of the rule, our the fulfillment of the time of the Gentiles. Israel will be on her own. Won't be no way we can help her. So the time of the end of the Gentiles is right here upon us right now. We are experiencing the end of the time of the Gentiles. Oh, it's a cow. The dog's barking at a cow. Shut up! I thought, you know, when I was listening to this, I'll play it. On the audio section here. Let's see if I can get this to come up. For those of y'all that don't like to read, I'll just go ahead and play it. And this player does much better than I can. Okay.
Against this people, they will fall by the sword and will be taken as prisoners to all the nations.
That's already happened.
Jerusalem will be trampled on by the Gentiles until the times of the Gentiles are fulfilled. There will be signs in the sun, moon, and stars. On the earth, nations will be in anguish and perplexity at the roaring and tossing of the sea. People will faint from terror, apprehensive of what is coming on the world, for the heavenly bodies will be shaken. At that time, they will see the Son of Man coming in a cloud with power and great glory. When these things begin to take place, stand up and lift up your heads, because your redemption is drawing near.